Yeah, the idea here is not to actually present the cons actually, but it's more, you know, to highlight the challenges, you know, that we are kind of interacting in following Scrum or Agile, whatever would be the buzzword. Now the problem is, you know, Scrum is being used as a buzzword in many organizations. Okay, we are Scrum, so let's become Scrum. So that's what, the Scrum is being forcefully applied into the organization without actually knowing what Scrum actually is all about. Right, so that is one of the challenge. The second challenge that we have seen that is, you know, Scrum is applied, no doubt, but you know, the mindset of people has not changed. The mindset is still on the waterfall mindset, right? Again, you know, there are questions when you know, you're trying to implement Scrum, that when I know my cost, when I know my scope, when I know my time, why should I go for Scrum? My waterfall is working fine, why should I go for Scrum, right? The fourth point, which we thought of was important, you know, in most of the organizations, what is happening is, I mean, where they are transforming to Agile, the customer project managers, they are kind of becoming, you know, the Scrum masters. Now, since their mindset has not changed, right, the command and control side of management is still prevailing. Instead of, you know, being acting as a facilitator, you know, that problem is still remaining. The command control style of management is still prevailing. Then there are challenges in distribution, scaling distribution. It's costly, it's expensive, right? Because there are teams which are geographically dispersed, working in different time zones. So it's difficult, you know, to get the teams that are, you know, synced up regularly. Another challenge, this is what, of course, I have been facing in my organization is, you know, the product owner, he belongs to the customer organization. So we have a proxy product owner who in turn, you know, doesn't have that much of, you know, voice over the customer. So the product owner belonging to the customer organization, the Scrum team or the development team, you know, is kind of handicapped. Then the seventh point is about the retrospectives. Now the retrospectives are just happening, you know, just for the sake of happening. They are not happening it's not effective, it's ineffective, right? The Scrum Masters are not using, you know, any innovative ways to make it more interesting. I mean, they are just going there, having a time box that what went well, what did not go well, what should you do for the next sprint. They are just doing it for the heck of doing it. And in continuation to this point, right, I want to just, you know, put forward one point. They're just using Scrum. I mean, that's a question for everyone. Are we actually becoming Scrum? Just by following, you know, the different kind of the rituals or the ceremonies, like sprint planning or the daily Scrum, or, you know, the reviews and the retrospective. Are we actually becoming Scrum? Are we actually seeing what is the value we are getting out of it? How many Scrum Masters, you know, take to see what is the value out of a daily Scrum call? I mean, that's a question for everyone. I mean, that's the challenge we are facing. Then, as Scrum is being forcefully applied in the organizations, right? So, in my organization, most of the projects are fixed price projects. So, how do you apply fixed price? How do you apply the Scrum principles on a fixed price project? You know the scope, time, cost, everything. So, go ahead and do it on waterfall. That's it. Velocity. Though some people are using Scrum, velocity is being used to measure the team's performance. Which should not be the case, right? My team and your team might be different. I might be working on a complex issue. He might be working on a simple issue. His velocity is high, my velocity is low. But that doesn't mean that I'm ineffective, right? And the last point is, you know, from the perspective of a customer. The customer feels, you know, I'm using, okay, the service industry is using Scrum. I can raise changes anytime I want. I can raise change late in the sprint. He doesn't understand, I mean, you know, incorporating changes late into the sprint involves a cost, right? So Scrum is expensive. I don't want to deny that it is not effective also. It is effective, but there are some challenges. And I'm sure, like, with Sanjay, Sakit, you guys could be able to, you know, tell us how we can, you know, come out of this.
Yeah, these are just the challenges we faced so far. I mean, not just we as a team, but all of us. But the thing is here, if you do this in a proper manner, for example, as my friend has mentioned, that the customer is keep asking the new things. Yeah, see, if I'm a customer, if I'm putting some money and investing some money in a product, so definitely if I say something as a ABC as a feature, after using it in my mind, if I say that, okay, if I just put one more feature in this so I can put a better quality or I can motivate my end user, business user, so why can't I ask team to just put this small feature inside this, so, or add this feature in this feature. So that customer used to ask, and we should accept that change. But if we respond in a proper manner, for example, if you say we have already developed this feature and it's in live, if you want to do it, we can do it, but it's impacting on your time and cost. So if you allow that, so in that case, the product owner, Scrum Master, and Scrum team. So Scrum team has that capability to say that, okay, boss, this is already in progress. We can't scrap this sprint and implement this change, or we can't incorporate this change in the sprint because of this. So these are the challenges. So if you communicate this in proper manner with the customer, the customer definitely understand your situation. And he said that, okay, just forget it, this sprint, but include in next sprint. But if that is the value is given to customer, then definitely we should accept it and respond in a proper manner. That's a responsive, that's a one of the manifesto of the Agile, that you should have responded in a proper manner so that customer will also understand.
So that is a very valid point. Yeah. All of these are very valid points, very common things which we keep discussing. The chain thing we did just discussed in PMICP class today. So I'll add more to it after maybe the second list of challenges. Right. So we'll just review a little bit of, we won't have time to discuss all the challenges, but the change in a sprint, how to handle that. Maybe we will take up that point. That's a very important point.
Because so this, I'm giving this my live example because I'm running two projects. One is a pure waterfall and one is a pure agile. But the Agile project I am doing, customer itself don't have any vision on that project. So it's a basically portfolio management application we are building. So they have just small idea. I mean, I would say 20-30% idea they would have in mind. And they say, okay, these are the only requests we do have, but we don't know how it products looks like at the end. But we need to do a lot of things. Those are coming from the end users, and we need to incorporate. So that's why, and we are delivering in a very good manner. So every day they are suggesting a new changes, but even though we are still delivering a good manner, good values to the customer. So if you follow properly, this will get a benefit.
In short, if you have very high uncertainty like that, changes are too many, Kanban might be slightly better.
Okay.
Because when there is a more chaotic kind of environment, Kanban works very well. You don't have concept of fixing the sprint scope and all those things. So we'll discuss that later. So we'll discuss the change, how to handle change in a sprint, and Kanban maybe sometime later. So let's review the other set of challenges.
Yeah. In this one point, PO belonging to the customer org, I think that is how it is. Product owner will be from the customer side.
Not always.
Generally, he will be from the client side.
Challenge.